guys. So this is probably gonna be one of many training videos that I do. I don't really know how I'm gonna structure these videos yet. I'm just starting with recording, you know. That's my thing. It's like, if you don't know how to do something, just start and figure out better ways of getting it done along the way, you know, trial and error. So I'm gonna record today. It may be kind of rough. I most likely will not be talking much while I'm training, because where we're going right now is a gym that you know, lets people choose what they want to listen to. It's not dictated by the owner of the gym. There's an iPod linked to the speaker, so, and most of the time people jack the volume up super high. So depending on where I, you know, plan on posting my training videos, whether it's going to be YouTube or Instagram, I may have to find some music to play over the video, so you won't hear a lot of the ongoings in the gym. That's mainly to avoid copyright issues for the songs. And so today I'm on my way to the gym. I'm gonna drink some of my pre-workout slash intro drink. This has 25 grams of carbohydrates in it, and also some aminos, some creatine, and try to get a little bit down, not half. I just maybe go about that much while I'm driving to the gym. And I also have a Monster right now, the low carb, low calorie Monster. And today I have quads. So prior to getting in the vehicle, heading on the way to the gym, I use a Compex on my quads, and also, you know, did some going through some movements, range of motion, like squatting, lunging with it. And, you know, for me, what that helps with is, you know, once I get to the gym, it helps me connect more efficiently with my, you know, the muscles that I'm focusing on training for that day. And today it's quads, so I'm gonna start with a little warm up, some lying leg curls, superset it with lunges, two sets, move on to leg extensions. Then, depending on how I feel, I'm gonna either do Bulgarian split squats or squat, one of those as a secondary movement. And whichever one I don't do secondary, I'll do as a third movement. Then go on to inner thigh machine, and then calves, abs, and cardio. I may do cardio before I do abs, so I like the way it feels to do it after my cardio, so I may do that. So I'm gonna turn this off, focus on driving, and then see you guys when I start my training. We'll be right back.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. But I'm just
here we are. I am trying to set this tripod up. Bear with me. It is not my favorite thing to do or try because I have yet to find a good tripod. So, just finished light training. Quad focus today, and it went fairly well. Through it all because one, it's very hot, and secondly, I only had one meal prior to training opposed to three meals. I normally do three. This is one scoop of protein, so it's 25 grams of protein in this, and I usually try to down it before I get home, because when I get home I'm going to have a meal, an actual meal, not a protein powder. And so I was like reviewing some of the images, which you guys have seen already, because once you get to this point, you have already seen everything that I just looked over before doing this part. And I noticed, like, I have my camera in movie mode, and it makes it more wide instead of, like, a bigger frame. So, although I thought I was positioning it properly, I can't see what I'm recording, because this camera doesn't have a viewer that, you know, rotates for me to see. So, a lot of the angles were, you know, you can see the movements, but it stopped around, like, my upper chest. Some had my face in it, but, so next time around, I'm gonna work on that, find better places to place my camera, and maybe more of an upright angle or something. For now, I'm training in this this gym, this warehouse gym. So I try to be considerate of others, and you know, try to stay out of the way and not have a huge tripod. That's why it's difficult for me to find a good tripod. I try to find something small instead of this huge elaborate setup. And but like here, within the next 2 months or so, I'm waiting on my own place that's gonna be built in my yard. So it's gonna be a warehouse. I already have equipment that I have in storage right now. We're just waiting on permitting. That has been taking a sweet while. You know, because I have to get permit for the huge concrete slab and the building as well. I already have the building. Everything's ready to go. We're just waiting on, you know, county to approve it. And you know, once that happens, concrete's gonna get put down, and maybe 2 weeks later the building's gonna be built on the slab, and you know, gonna get ready to go. I'll start filming in there without any fans or power in there, whatever. Maybe have a spotlight for now until I can get electricity in there, but I'm not really gonna focus on having AC or anything like that. Maybe like a few fans here and there, and trying to find the right lighting, because I have astigmatism, so like a lot of gym lighting messes with my eyes, gives me a headache, and so most of the time I don't have my glasses on, and I just try to avoid lights, but it really messes with me. I start seeing like dots everywhere, and then also all the lights are blurry, everything's blurry, so my vision is horrible in the gym because of the types of lighting people choose to put in their facility. So that's going to be a thing for me to, you know, read up on what type of lighting I can have that it's not going to give me issues while I train, because you know, my warehouse is for me privately, so I'm not going to think about anybody else and what they want in my facility. So all right, so I'm doing my post-workout. This is rice cakes. I measured it out to 60 grams on the scale, and this is what I've been doing every day for the last I'm probably like 3 to 4 months. I'm not in prep. If I start prepping, or let's say I'm trying to reduce body fat, this is what will change. Sometimes I don't even have a carbohydrate post-workout meal. It's just like protein powder, depending on, you know, just how my body responds. And pre-training is also what changes. Sometimes I'll have more carbs, or no carbs or little carbs during. Also, my carbohydrate fluctuates. Right now, I'm doing 25 grams. When I was prepping for a show, I didn't have any carb powder during my training. It was just aminos, creatine, and it's harder, but you know, whatever. So right now I'm doing 25 grams of carbohydrates. Right now, I'm not really particular on the type of carbohydrate. I'm doing, I think it's called Carbaline or whatever. It's not my favorite, but it's for me, because I use it every day. I want something that's gonna last me longer. So it's more cost efficient versus, you know, getting Vitargo, which has a little can or little, you know, thing and minimal servings, and it costs much more. So that, or I'll do Jet Mass. Since I'm not in prep, I'll do Jet Mass, but that doesn't have enough carbs per serving, so I do have to add some Carbaline to it to get the desired carbohydrates that I want. When I go into prep, I'm not gonna have the Jet Mass anymore, because I like to actually control everything that goes into my whole diet. So, alrighty, that's it for today's little, I don't even know what to call this. I don't even know. I'm not really doing this for educational purposes. This is just, you know, to share things I do, since I really am not the best at being interactive with everyone. Like, I try to comment here and there to people, and then I do the questionnaires and my stories and all that, but I figured this would be like a better way for me to, you know, I guess you would say, reach my audience, versus, you know, trying to do that in my stories and via comments. And I know myself, you know, when I'm going through things, like, not mentally, but, you know, like training, the things I'm doing, like my prep or not prepping off season, I like watching others going through it as well, because I'm very, I'm an introvert, and I like being alone. I don't have groups of friends. I do have friends, but all of us have our own lives, so I'm usually alone unless I'm with my kids. And, you know, my hobby thing that I like doing, the bodybuilding, I do it alone. The only person I correspond with is, you know, the person doing my programming, and that's about it. And, you know, I like it. Some people might think, oh, that's a sad life and all that, but like, I really enjoy it. Like, too many people, too much me giving away a lot of energy, like, drains me, drains the crap out of me, and I have to, you know, I've tried balancing it, but that I could only hold up, like, put up with, you know, trying to give my energy to a lot of people, you know, all my friends, until I crash. And you know, so it is what it is, you know. The type of person I am isn't for everybody, and you know, the people who understand are the people who are meant to be in your circle. All right, that's it for now. I'm gonna get driving and head back.